loves. This is the altar spread for the collective today. So the sacred geometry that showed up today was Earth Grid. This is the dodeca icosahedron. This talks about our connection with Gaia. But what it talks about is every decision we've ever made affects the continuum. And certain environments, because it's all about community, it's about the collective unconsciousness. So it's all about community and how we move through different environments. And so what this card actually shows up is to ask you, how do you feel when you come out of a certain environment? Whether it be work, school, church, I mean, wherever you're going where you are communing with a group of people. Because this is affected by the ley lines, by the energetic forces that are within Gaia, but also yourself. So how are you feeling? Are you feeling energized? Are you feeling drained? And start choosing the environments that feed you instead of sap you of all of your life force. This is a good card because this will start really amplifying where you are denying joy for yourself and how you continue to perpetuate lies in your life and disharmony. And sacrifice actually showed up in the reverse. So sacrifice always talks about making sacred, right? That's what the word means, the sacrifice. To sacrifice something means to make it sacred. But showing up in the reverse, because the only thing that is sacred enough to approach your altar with and offer is you, your love, your heart. But in the reverse, it's telling you, you have put far too much importance in some past item, whether it be a person or a thing, but your attachment is causing great disharmony. And so it's telling you, take that thing or that person and offer it. Let it go. And watch what the freedom from attachment does for you. It opens you to a greater level of connection. It's like cutting those sandbags off of the hot air balloon, which I use as an analogy quite often. But so this wants you to pay attention to your community. This wants you to pay attention to you. Like, what are you attaching yourself to? And then divine communion. This is about communion with self. But amethyst will help facilitate that. Amethyst is the stone of ascension, but I always refer to it as like the jack of all trades when it comes to crystals. I love amethyst because amethyst is not only purifying, but it's calming. It's such a beautiful stone of ascension because other ascension crystals can be quite intense. And if you are not grounded or actually ready, it can cause, other stones can cause headaches, can cause, the misfiring of your own prana and chi, or chi, however you want to refer to your energy, in your earth suit, in your skin. But amethyst is always such a beautiful vibration, and it will help facilitate that. So the affirmation for amethyst is, I am open to divine guidance. Carrying amethyst will actually help magnify those synchronicities so that you are more aware, because that makes the path way more clear. Whenever you're confused, you are portraying someone else's version of you. You're not even being authentic or honest. So just be aware of that. How often are you confused in your days? Pay attention to the environment that confuses you. Pay attention to the thing that you always go back to. It very well could be holding you down. And then Chaska, the star of Venus, talks about abundance, that you have come into this human experience to experience abundance and to release any ideas or beliefs about scarcity or lack. And there is a prayer for this. So let's take a deep collective inhale. Release with an audible sigh. Close your eyes, shake out your shoulders, stay connected to my voice. I give thanks for the abundance of grace available for all beings. I open my heart to let go of diminishing beliefs and interpretations of events. I no longer carry fear in my heart. My heart is filled with trust and peace. I give thanks for divine intervention, innovation, and blessings on behalf of all beings in all matters. Great Spirit of love, please guide, assist, and protect each one of us in all worldly matters. By the morning star, the great divine beloved spirit now gifts me with all that I need for divine fulfillment, for the overflowing of divine grace into this world so that love will flourish through all beings. I hope.